And so now I'm going to show you what the Israeli army is doing to support the left-wing view.
Our goal is to try to provide as much information online as possible, material that previously was the exclusive purview of traditional journalists is now available to everybody.
It is well known nowadays that what happens on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube has great influence on events as they occur on the ground. The internet, too, is a battleground. It is thus comforting to learn that the IDF employs soldiers whose job titles are new to the military world. The IDF now has soldiers who tweet, share, like, and more. We meet the soldiers of the IDF spokesman's unit, New Media Desk, on another routine day in which they surf the web's blogs and social networks.
I also do all the routine things, updating the blog, updating the Twitter. I'm in constant contact with the film unit for pictures and videos and items. And I also do more emergent things like when we have questions from bloggers, when we need to set up phone briefings or face-to-face briefings. We deal with bloggers and we try to treat them the way that we treat journalists, but with recognition for the different ways that they operate. Bloggers don't claim to be objective. Their blog is very much an extension of their personality and their beliefs. And their readers, whether they agree with them or not, come because they want to hear that point of view. So the bloggers we work with come to us because they want the information that we can give them to portray their point of view. One of the biggest projects we had was Michael Totten visiting. He was here for about a month, a week and a half of which he dedicated to really letting us show him around, briefings on the northern border, briefings on our military doctrine. And it was really fascinating to see a blogger come and really get VIP treatment. He got all sorts of briefings. A while later, we have this huge post about how he got a lot of IDF briefings, how much he learned, how much he discovered that he didn't know.
The team was founded when two soldiers came up with the initiative to open a YouTube channel during Operation Cast Lead. The channel had 11 million views over the past year and a total of 20 million views to date. The team was especially busy after the Marmara raid in May. The soldiers worked around the clock.
The Gaza flotilla organizers were very savvy, I must say, in terms of their new media operations. They had Twitter going and, website charting their progress and exactly what they were doing, and they were broadcasting video. And it was very important for us to also operate in that field. And I think that once the videos came out where you saw what had happened to the soldiers going on to the ship, that really had a profound impact on the way that people conceptualized the entire event. And one of the things that we saw was immediately just millions of hits on those videos, and they became the most watched videos for about 2 to 3 days in the world.
The readers' response or talkbacks are also an opening for much anti-Israel and anti-Semitic content. The IDF blocked the option of talkbacks to videos on its YouTube channel. However, it promises that on other channels, which include a Facebook page that is about to be launched, serious and respectable comments will be allowed, and the IDF will answer them.
We had comments open on our YouTube channel, and that did not work out particularly well. People were writing really horrific comments that were just incredibly inappropriate, and because it's our channel, our platform, we are ultimately responsible for everything that gets written up there, which is why we had to close comments.
Well, you get very positive and very negative responses. They're polarized in each direction. A lot of the time, they're almost never moderate.
Well, some have called this the hacker unit. The New Media Desk members stress that they do not engage in hacking enemy sites.
We don't even say, oh yeah, our desk is hackers. It would lead to the wrong conclusions if you took it literally. New media is a new medium in order to disseminate information. That's it. We don't hack things. There's no black ops going on our desk.
And so now I'm going to show you an item to do with the anti-Zionist movement and the Zionist movement. And of course, the Zionist movement is on the left wing and the anti-Zionist movement is on the right wing.
Moetzet Yesh, in conjunction with My Israel, has arranged instruction day for wiki editors. The goal of the day is to teach people how to edit in Wikipedia, which is the number one source of information today in the world. As a way of example, if someone searches the Gaza flotilla, we want to be there. We want to be the guys who influence what is written there, how it's written, and to ensure that it's balanced and Zionist in nature.
I came here to learn more about how we as Israelis and as Jews can defend Israel online, on the internet, and particularly in Wikipedia in this case. Wikipedia is a bit of a complex system and it's sometimes hard to figure out the rules. I've personally tried to edit things in Wikipedia that were against Israel, small things, and my changes were erased or undone, and I didn't understand why. And I think that this kind of knowledge is important for anyone who wants to be active in defending Israel on the internet, so that we can go and we can see the information and we can say this isn't quite right, it's showing one side of the story, and I have the power and the right to change that. And in general, it's so important for us to be online working to defend ourselves and to prove to the world and to ourselves that we are just and we are right. And because right now, if you look online, if you do searches for certain terms related to Israel, it's just filled with anti-Semitism, anti-Zionism, and garbage. And there's not enough of us out there working to counteract that and make sure that the other side of the story, our side of the story, and our right side of the story is getting the right coverage and the coverage that it needs. So this type of initiative, and initiatives like that, to educate and promote defense of Israel online are extremely important, and I hope we'll see more of them.
Say the fear of the Lord is gone.